Let's talk education, shall we? I have been an educator for quite some time now in the industry, and I want to help you be a better consumer of education. So this whole video is really going to focus on how to see the red flags in possible scamming situations or unprofessional, unwarranted, ungood, not great education, and also what to look for. What are the things that we want to see and want to find and want to understand about educating ourselves to be better consumers of education? So let's get started. First, let's talk about value and what's valuable to you. But what I want to be really clear about is that I'm not talking about how expensive or inexpensive the education is, but rather what you're receiving and what is really good and feels great for you. For value, is that one-on-one time with the educator? Is that going to be hands-on education? Is that super valuable to you? Are you product focused, and is the course product focused, and is that something that you think is valuable to receive product during a training? Or are you more focused on the education? Does the education also checkmark all the things that you want to learn, and do you feel like you are going to leave there learning and answering the questions that you've been sitting on for a while? Those sorts of things are all super valuable, and they also really do play a hand in what your focus is going to be. So that's the really big second point that I want to drive here, is that do you have a focus? And when I'm talking about a focus, I really want you to think about what your focus is in a year-long type of goal. And in that year, are you maybe focused on, for me, coming 2020, I'm super focused on really elevating my beauty portfolio and also capturing my own beauty portfolio and growing my photography. That's something that is super focused for me. And so I'm really going to drive in investing money in that world. Something to also consider when looking into education and investing in your education as a makeup artist is, what kind of learner are you anyways? We could really span a whole wide range of different types of ways that we like to learn. Visual. We are all definitely super hyper-visual learners. There's also physical learners who are really gonna love a hands-on approach. They wanna work one-on-one, they wanna physically repeat the techniques and the steps. I think that's a lot of us as well. There's oral learners too, who like to learn in the presence of music and vibration, and it really helps them connect with their memory flow and really taking in information. There's also verbal learners. So verbal learners are going to be the ones who they like to take notes. They always have a notebook with them. They're really jotting down. Words are really sexy to them. And they like to repeat things too. So if they hear maybe a word or a phrase they haven't heard before, they might even sound it out loud. I've done that before. Then we have logical learners. Logical learners are some of my favorite types of learners. When I'm putting on education, they ask a ton of questions. They really need to methodically hear you answer what they need to spell out in their head. And they'll also take a lot of notes as well. Then we have social learners. Social learners enjoy going to workshops. They enjoy having multiple people around. They enjoy learning and watching by seeing what other people are doing. So usually that's a lot of ways of how workshops are set up, is to provide that education in a social atmosphere so that you can brainstorm off of each other, you can pick up on each other's kind of vibes and auras. A lot of people tend to leave from these types of workshops really excited because they've socialized and they've met other people they can connect with. So that tends to really fall in our realm as well as makeup artists. And then lastly is the solitary learner. And the solitary learner is definitely me as well. I checkmark all of these. I do love to learn a lot on my own, and I do go out and seek out information on my own a lot. And those really fall well into the realm of our new online education programs, where you can learn by yourself in the comfort of your home without any other distractions. So that's also something to consider as well. If you really enjoy kind of, you have a little social anxiety and you have a hard time being around large groups of people, maybe being aware of your class size might be smaller, that might be more comfortable for you, or you might be a great candidate for online education. So those are things to really consider is, how do I like to learn? What is the one thing that really helps me learn the best? And focus on those types of education that is being offered out there. Okay, so let's get a little cereal right now and let's talk about the red flags. Red flag number one, they're asking you to pay on a secondary app platform such as Cash App, Venmo, Zelle, etc. Those apps offer zero protection. Here's an example of what a refund looks like from Cash App and what a refund looks like from Venmo. They do not offer any sort of refund protection when it comes to you being dissatisfied with a education scenario. There is a super popular online Instagram makeup artist who is well known for scamming tons of people, and the number one thing that this person uses is Cash App. They also, in red flag number two, require you to book services through private messaging. If someone is asking you to DM them through either Facebook, Instagram, some sort of social media platform, and they want you to pay them through their Cash App handle or their Venmo handle, red flags should be flying up right there. Those are two things to look out for immediately, is that they are not valuing their business. So the best way to look for education and payment, and which is rather really easy to do versus giving someone your credit card information, is PayPal. PayPal's got you covered. PayPal covers you as a consumer. They also cover you as a business. So if someone doesn't want to accept the business charges that come with services like PayPal or Stripe, then they're not a credible business and they are not somebody you want to give your hard-earned money to because they don't value themselves as a business. Red flag number three is going to be overpromising. These people are really trying to upsell you. They're starting to say these really kind of garish, you know, lavish things to really lure you in. They're telling you that they're going to give you extra this. They're going to give you, put you into some kind of incentive program. They're going to have special guests that are kind of guests that maybe wouldn't necessarily be a part of something like this. They're really overpromising a lot of things to get you to purchase in. And that should be something to consider if it's really legit or not. Next red flag number four is website. Do they have a website? A lot of these people don't have business websites. Why? Because again, they are not paying the money into their business. They're not treating it like a business. Anybody who is running a full-fledged, really high-level education, they have all of these things. They cover the bases. They pay these fees to run these business programs for you. And then lastly, red flag number five, there's no reviews anywhere. They don't have anybody talking about them and celebrating them and their services. Now, we know reviews can be a little shaky because we know that people pay for reviews as well. A lot of businesses have been called out for this, but I also still want to see that there's somewhere where they're celebrating the people who have attended and what the attendees have to say about it. So real quick, what do we want to look for? This is what we want to look for. Do they have a website? Do they have a secure form of payment, right? Do they have great reviews? Do they have actual real people that you can find and search and know that they have attended? Do they also offer the type of workshop that you're looking for? So what's your focus for that year? And what's the way that you like to learn? Are they offering that? Is it just a demo only? Do you not like demos? Do you want to have hands-on to be integrated in that? Sometimes demo only is necessary and really good and works really well. Sometimes it's not. And then lastly, what does their body of work look like? Have you actually gone and verified through their portfolio all the things that they have done, all the type of different work that they have done? Does that work focus on what they're going to teach you? Do you love their work? Are you like, oh my God, it's when I look at photographers and I'm like, oh, I love this body of work. It's so good. Are they going to teach me something like that? Yes, cool. Sign me up. I'll pay for it. So those are the great things to consider when going to find the education that's right for you. So let's be real. There are some things we just cannot prevent when we do go into education and purchasing services like this. These are just things that we are going to have to learn through experience or through the experience of somebody else, unfortunately. So some of those things are going to be timeliness. Did they actually show up? Did the educator show up on time? Or did they just not show up at all? That's something we don't know about until it actually happens. And this is a very common trend that does happen with this online scammer, is that they're promising these workshops and then they just don't show. And they're constantly telling people over and over again that their flight was canceled and they have to rebook and you can rebook with me in the future. Those are definitely things that you want to consider in the future if you actually want to rebook with them. Do they offer a refund? We don't even know this until we actually go through and have an unsuccessful type of education and we go, you know what, that wasn't great. They didn't show up. I want my money back. Do they refund back? Refunding can be hairy scary. A lot of times we have to take into consideration that force majeure can happen, and that is just a natural act of something bad in the family happening, emergencies, a hurricane comes in and cancels the workshop. Those types of things, of course, should be rescheduled and retried for in the future. And that's okay, but you may not be able to reschedule. So will they still refund you? That's something that you really want to make sure is available. So definitely even check beforehand if they do offer a refund policy or not. Most of the time they may not, because that's just how education works. But will they be able to protect you in the case that your flight is canceled, their flight is canceled, XYZ? Something to ask about. Do they miss on their promises? So they promised you food, they promised you models, they promised you product. Are you getting all those things, or did you not receive any of that? So how is that going to relay in the future to you suggesting this workshop to somebody else? Or is that going to fall into any kind of partial refund? Those are things to consider as well. Are they under promising their promises? There can also be scenarios that we can't control, whereas we've gone into the workshop and we had a very unpleasant experience. And I've heard of this happening before, unfortunately, many times. And that is where the way the education was relayed was very demeaning, dismissive, aggressive. I have actually had people come to me and tell me that they've had their hands slapped during learning. Or that the overall vibe from the educator was very belittling. Those, again, are things we don't know until we actually have taken that workshop, and probably some of the worst things that I can hear coming from education. It really disheartens me to know that there are people out there that don't take education as amazing as I take it, as excitable as I like to take it, or as inspiring as I've received from other educators. So again, that's something that we can't control, but we can definitely talk about it. So to sum all of this up, if you've ever experienced really great education, tell people about it. If you've ever experienced really bad education, tell people about it. Let's be more open and more communicative about how we love to receive education and how we don't love to receive education, and let's all grow from this experience. I really hope this helps you find out how to be a better consumer of education, where your hard-earned money is going, and getting and receiving the value that you deserve. See you later.